lion, tigers, and people. Oh, yes. Painting tutorial. Wildlife classes. Well, hello again. It is Johnny. How to paint lion, tigers, and people. So y'all can see right here in this corner right here, you see the eyeball, the leopard's eyeball on my laptop. So rather than using photos, I use my laptop because I enlarge it and make it smaller when necessary. Okay, and I'll be painting on a 8x8 stretch canvas, you know, wrap around. And well, let's see how long it takes. And I want to make it super realistic, but I still want to see how quick I can do it and do it properly. Remember, with oil paints, we're painting from dark to light. All right, thanks for checking it out. Okay, I normally sketch, but the eyeball is so impersonal. And I'll just paint it in. And it's a close-up. I'm doing a close-up. I don't know how much y'all notice my reference, but yeah, it was a close-up. But it's pretty easy, you know, eyeball. Pretty simple to paint. So I won't have to spray my pencil lead because you'll be painting right on your paint. You're starting right off with your oil paints. And I didn't add any liquid because I think I'll finish this fast enough without really even needing it. You know, mostly this is burnt umber with a little cobalt blue in it to cool it off. You know, so it won't be too reddish. I like to keep it cool. Then I brighten it up as in the highlights. I like to brighten it up in the highlights, and I'll pause sometime because I'm trying to talk and concentrate on what I'm doing too. But you know what advantage I have? Growing up as a child, my friends would stand over my shoulder and talk to me all the time while I'm drawing. In art school, they used to ask me, how can you just talk so much and still do your work and stay focused? I said, thanks to my buddies. Growing up, they would not be quiet. Okay, I have all of my paint mixed so I can cover everything. So I'll go ahead and get this part of the eye. I have two images. One of them is more orange, and one of them is more greenish, pale green. This is mostly yellow ochre with Rizalin. Listen to me, Rizalin. I mean cerulean blue. Rizalin crimson won't come along until I do mine. Remember, you don't paint black. You use ultramarine and Rizalin crimson to create your darkest color. You might add a tab of black in it. Thank you. things in here. But highlights a lighter color, I'm sorry. You know, looking at the eyeball. You know, the eyeball close-up has a lot going on inside of it. Let's work on some of these lighter hairs. I'll help it pop out some. Thank you. JohnnyMyersStudio.com. Secure transactions online. Portraits. Mick Jagger, Steve Harvey. American history. Limited editions. Wildlife on canvas. Waterproof canvas. Educational. Inspirational. Your artistic journey is complete here. First of all, you ever study the eyeball, you know all of this stuff here is a moving tissue and muscles inside, so let me kind of pull that out. Okay, I'm back. I was working on it last night. But I've noticed I'm looking at two different eyeballs. The one with the where the eyes closer and more angry is really more exciting. I'm not going to make it angry. But I notice I do like the one that's more intense. So I'm going to make some changes right here, right now. Thank you. All right, let's make these eyeballs pop. Reflections in the shadow. Instead of doing the highlights, I'm going to add some tan colors here. Okay, let's work on the what people perceive to be orange in photography. But at the zoo, they're not orange at all. Faint orange, not much. But the orange, when they bring it out in the photos, okay, this is the final stretch, but I'm going to stick my silhouette in there, but I'm going to finish it first. That'll just be a little bonus activity that I'll film. Right now, I want to get all these shadows right here. Get all of this finished. So it's an 8-inch by 8-inch canvas. Took me about 3.5 hours, about 3 hours, 15 minutes to do the tiger itself, and then I took a little time and indulged in my little silliness and put my little portrait in there. I have finished. I've added my little reflection in there, but it's too much. So I have to tone it down just a touch. When I add, when I darken the lower part of my body in the reflection, now it looks more natural. I saw in some things online, you know, the reflection did come down, but it kind of went across there, and I didn't want to do that to the eyeball, you know, even the background lights just came across like that, which is, you know, more natural. But for this one personally, I just kind of just faded all the way up to my shoulder and neck, darkened it, and it looked better to me. All right, let me know what you all think about that reflection. All right, take care.